Hello friends, welcome to this course again. The course is Data Structure Using C and C++. In the last video, we have discussed what is data structure, what are different types of data structures, and we have also discussed what is program. Now, let us see all these terms again. So, data structure we mean organization of data in the main memory. This data are used by a program. So, data structure means how we store data, what are the relationships among them, how it is accessed, all these are connected with data structures. As we have discussed in the last video, basically, we have two types of data structures, physical data structure and logical data structure. In the physical data structure, we have seen the examples of array and linked list. Whereas logical data structures, we have seen the examples like stack, queue, trees and graphs. So, physical data structure means how data is stored, and logical data means how data is accessed. For example, we have stored 10 elements in a sequence, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Now, if we access data in the way it is inserted, that is first in, first out. We call it as a FIFO discipline. If we access data as last in, first out, this is another way. This is called LIFO discipline. So, if we access data in FIFO discipline, it is called queue. If we access data in LIFO discipline, it is called stack. So, in short, storage of the data physically, how we are storing it is called physical data structure, and how we are accessing the stored data, it is called the logical data structures. Now, what is program? We have seen in the last lecture that a set of instructions which perform operations on data is called a program. We had discussed the example of creating a document. So, whenever you open a Word file, then that will be considered as a code file. And when you open a new document, then it will be a data. So, program is basically has two parts, data and the set of instructions. So, this we have discussed in the last lectures. Now, let us see, in this video we will discuss variables, we will see some sample C program, we see monolithic programming and modular programming, what are the difference between these two, different data types, memory allocation to the variables and activation record. Variables. Friends, variables means we give the name to the space. For example, as we have seen, that program needs data. Without data, program has nothing to do. So, whenever we run any program, whenever we execute any program, we need to store data. To store the data, we need space. So, when we store the data, it is assumed that in future, we would use them. So, when we want to use the stored data, we have to give some name. That is nothing but a variable. For example, in mathematics, we have seen that fx is a function of say x. Say fx is equal to x square plus 2x plus 3. So here x is a variable. X may be 2, x may be 3, x may be 5. But x cannot be two value at a time. It cannot be 2 and 5 both. It can be either 2 or it can be either 5. So similarly here, variable name, or we can say simply variable, is a space where one value can be stored. So this variable has basically two parts. Name, for example, say x is a name and we store 5 in x, so 5 is a data. So whenever we say x, its stored value 5 is a data. Now types of variables. So basically we are storing different types of values in a variable. For example, we want to store the roll number, then it will be only numeric quantity. But if we want to store our name, then it will be alphabetic. Sometimes we need to store numeric and alphabetic combined. For example, address of our house. So we say bungalow number and name of the society. That means it is, bungalow number is numeric, name of the society is alphabetic. So sometimes mixing of these two is also required. So alphanumeric contains alphabetic. That means basically we will have only two types, that is numeric type and alphanumeric type. In the programming languages, these alphanumeric type of variables are known as text or character. So we have some numeric data and we have some alphanumeric data. So basically we have two types of variables, numeric and alphanumeric. Alphabetic is of course another type, but it is included in the alphanumeric, and that's why we have basically two types of variables. Now these variables are required to be stored and with which has a different types. Now in each language there are different data types. These different data types show us which kind of values we are going to store in the variables. We will definitely discuss in more details about different data types in the next sessions. But till now, let us see, variables are used to store the data and to access the data. Now, as we have seen, variables are nothing but a space where we are storing the data. So whenever we give any name to a variable, we have to declare in the program before using it with corresponding data type that which type of value we are going to store in that particular variable. So these variables are allocated some memory. Now let us come to the program part. Programs are normally written in English-like language, but computer can understand only binary languages, and therefore there is some intermediate program is required which convert our English-like language written program into a language which a machine can understand. And therefore this intermediate program is called either compiler or interpreter. So program is written in English like language, it is converted into machine like language, and then machine will follow those instructions. This program execution has basically two parts, one is compilation part, other one is execution part. So whenever any memory allocated at the time of compilation, then it is called a static memory allocation, and when memory is allocated during runtime, it is called dynamic memory allocation. The static memory allocation and dynamic memory allocation we will definitely discuss later, this is simply an introduction part of the allocation of the memory. Now, let us see a program. Basically, program has three parts: input, process, and output. We have to give something to the computer. It will process and output will be given. So, this is a sample program that we are giving some name to the program, for example, main here. Okay, these two are the variables x and y and z. This is the declaration part of the variable. Here we are declaring the variable x and y of integer type. That means we can store integer value, numeric value in x and y. Again, z is an integer type of variable, so we can store some value in the z also, which must be an integer. So whenever these variables are declared, the memory will be allocated to these variables. Now this memory will be allocated from the stack section of the main memory. We have already discussed that main memory is divided in three parts: code section, stack section, and heap section. Code section will contain the code of the program, and data will be stored in the stack section. So you can see in the figure that the three variables we have declared, x, y, and z, are stored in the stack section. Then we are making process. X equal to z plus 10. This is process part. Y equal to z minus 10. This is process part. So here x will be z plus 5. Z is initialized with value 5. That means initially we have assigned 5 value to z. So whenever z will be used, its value will be 5. So x is equal to 5 plus 10. So now x will become 15. And y is equal to z minus 10. That is 5 minus 10. That is minus 5. Y will become minus 5. And this statement is output statement. Here we are printing x and y variables. So this is input statement where we are declaring the variable. This is the process statement where we do some arithmetic process as well as we are assigning some values. And also the third part is the output, means whatever the required result we want, we can send it to the console, that is monitor, or we can send it to the printer. This monitor and printer are called the output devices. So input will be from input device, there will be process, and output will send to any output device. Here we can see output is equal to 15 and minus 5, which we can see on the monitor when we run this program. Here all the process we have done only in one function, that is main. So this program is also called a function. So main function contains all the instructions which we want to perform, which we want to use in the program. So when all the codes are written only in one program, it is called monolithic programming. Here you can see I have written one main program with initial variables A, B, and C. I am assigning 10 value to A, 20 value to B. So A and B are the variables, 10 and 20 are the data. C is equal to add AB. Now this add is another function which I have written here before the main program. So we are calling this function with the values A and B. Now here in this function, we have two different values, X and Y, corresponds to these two values A and B. So whenever this function will be called, value of X will be equal to same as value of A, that is 10, and value of Y will same as value of B, that is 20. So before we reach to these statements, the value of X is 10, the value of Y is 20. And this is nothing but initialization, or we can say declaration. So type of X is integer and type of Y is integer. we need another variable, say z. So we declare here in the in this function integer z. Z is equal to x plus 5. So we know x is equal to 10, y is equal to 20. So our z will be equal to 30. Return z. So we can go back from this function with the help of return statement. So this return statement will return the value of z, and this will be at the same place from where this function was called. So here we call this function using this statement. So the value will return to this, and we are storing this return value in the C. So C will be equal to 30. We are printing C and its output is 30. So here this program, adding of the two numbers, is written with the help of two functions. So when these codes are written in more than one functions, and it is managed only in one function, that is main function, then it is called modular programming. Now the last point left, that is activation record. Now when we start any program, then the main program and the functions, their coding will be stored in the code section. Now when main program is executed, here for example we have three variables A, B and C. So A, B and C will be stored in the stack section, and that is called the activation record of main. When the function add will be called, then the variables of the add function will be allocated space from the stack section, and that will be known as activation record for add. Now when any return statement will be encountered, then the control will pass again back to the main function. So as and when this add function will be closed, control will return to the main program, then automatically the activation record add will be deleted. That's all for today, friends. Thank you very much.